Hey everyone, this is Gus. Welcome to my new transmission. Well, I'm just checking that we are somewhere, we are live in YouTube. Yeah, so we're finally there. And what I'm doing right now is first I'm gonna answer the question of the ages for us, the guys who does art and like digital or traditional. First off, will a Wacom make you a better artist? The answer is no. Tablet for the cheapest, I guess, is around 500. The Intuos is pretty much like that. To the most expensive, which is the Wacom Pro and the Cintiq Pro, around the 2000s or 3000-ish. They are tools. It's like having one of these pencils, for example. You have one pencil. Okay, let me tell you something about pencils. They are all the same, they all have graphite. They all have this carbon. So pencils, their main purpose of the pencil is to draw and sometimes shading. But if you find out some kind of pencil that is, has some pure graphite, something like take out of the mines or whatever, the mine shops where you get graphite, these, not that these days, I don't know, it's a mineral carbon. It doesn't matter. You are not going to be a better artist. What makes you a better artist is the constant practice, is study. We never left to study. We are always studying. It doesn't matter how old you are not a know-it-all. Nobody knows it all. And you have to be humble and also a good person. A good artist is always a good person. There is not such thing, we have egos, but there is no such thing like an artist that is only looking to his benefit against the benefits of others. So that is the, when I was working in advertising agencies, that was the advice that my creative director at that time when I was young told me. A good artist is always a good guy, a good person. So yeah, take that in mind. Also, again, for the Wacom, well, probably in the past, yeah, having a Wacom was a nice advantage. That's true. Either that Intuos, the bamboo pen, all those kinds, that from the cheapest to the most expensive Wacom, having one was a really, really, really advantage. But seriously, nowadays, there is so many in the market. We have this brand known as XP Pen. We have Huion. We have Pablo. We have Pablo, I guess it is. We have Artisu. We have Mastic. We have a bunch. And it doesn't matter if they looks like a bad for you. True is, Wacom is a tool. The other brands are a tool too. So you can be a sculptor either using a chisel made out of titanium from one of the cheapest ones that you can find in YouTube or in PayPal, in eBay or even in Home Depot. So yeah, it's not that you automatically gonna be an artist if you have a Wacom. What I recommend, if you are aiming for a Wacom, just save money. That's it. But the cheapest one is the Wacom One, which is not as good as you compare it with the Cintiq 16. The Cintiq 16 is 650, the Wacom One is 400. So yeah, one is 16, as the name, 1616, and the other is around 13. So yeah. If you want 3 extra inches, you have to pay like 200 more. Yeah, and it's a Wacom, it's okay. But if you want the 30 inches, the 24 or 27, I don't know what, which one is. Well, that is starting at 2,000 up. Or if you want that the Wacom that is 16 inches that looks like it's a computer per se. So yeah, that is $2,000 too. But the alternative for those guys, yeah, that's easy. Either iPad Pro, which is $1,000. Better case is this Black Friday, probably they lower the prices. That is very good. And also you have the Surface Pro, $500, $600, $700, $800, $1,000. It depends on the configuration you want. Yeah. So it's cheaper than buying a Wacom. And by the way, I guess there is a Wacom pen that works perfect with the Surface Pro too. So yeah, it's okay. Well, so on the other side of the spectrum, every time that you see a review, I seen one guy that wasn't review was making about the new XP Pen 24 Pro, which is the 24 inches is bigger than the monitor I have. Well, I have two actually, but they are pretty much the same, 24. Yeah, pretty much it's the same size. And this 24, he started saying, this is not for professional artists. Well, define professional artist, because I'm a professional one. I do this for a living, so, and I don't have a Wacom, because I just know that the Wacoms and the other brands are pretty much considerably the same. Probably Wacom's more sturdy, they have more money to put into the UI design and more money to put into drivers and that kind of stuff. Yeah, yes or no, but not necessarily that way. If you go to the specs, many of the Wacom Cintiq 16 that has is $600 is not even like the 16 Pro from the XP Pen or for Huion, who has also this kind of TL configuration. They have the less space between the glass and the pen, which is in the 15.6 that I have. It's okay, but it's not the less. So yeah, it doesn't matter. This tablet I have working with me, I have this working with me for almost, 3 years now. I bought it when they just started getting in the market in December 2016, it's almost for a year. This December is gonna be 4 years. So yeah, and I'm been producing art. You are a witness for that. You bear witness that I've been producing art with this. So the next time that somebody tell you, oh, well, this is not for a professional. There was in Grombacher, Bilbo, Winston Newton, and those brands in Da Vinci's era. They made their own oils. You can make your own oils, by the way, too, and acrylics, too. And the difference is they have the machines. They can do it faster and better. And probably they can save you some money in the carpet because it's just stained using oil. It's going to be pretty bad. But anyway, it doesn't matter. It's just a tool. As I told you, you can do a nice sculpture using the cheapest tools that you can buy in Michael's, or the most expensive tools that you can buy in Utrecht.com or some places where you can find specialized tools for sculpting that uses titanium or some kind of metal, I don't know. But anyway, let me tell you this. Don't go to the reviews, but just think of this. Many places send their tablets or their display tablets to somebody to try them, but this somebody already has a Wacom. So the Wacom is pretty much like a or I want to have it, and this is the trend. This is what it is in history of art, which is not. Wacom is not the trend, it's just a tool. It's expensive, and I wish I had one, because I've seen many things that people do with Wacom, but that doesn't mean I cannot do the same with an Archisoul, with a Huion, or an XP-Bank. It's pretty much the same. Because what is worth is this, and this, not that. You can make great art, pen and paper. You can make great art with a Wacom. You can make even great art with an XP-Pen, with a Huion, or with an Archisoul, or with a Pablo. Whatever is the flavor you want it, you can do it. So that is this kind of thing that was tickling me. And said, oh, I have to talk to the guys that is watching my transmissions. What is my opinion? Where I stand for? If I can buy a Wacom, that's cool. I will do it. Well, welcome again to my transmission. We are gonna do Gothic, because GothicStyle is making this contest with this, how can you say that? With this special, it's called the tips of GothicStyle, tips of the month. And if you put the tips of the month and whatever they are looking for, you can have, and you are the best, you can have the opportunity to make $10,000. They said, well, at least it's 10 winners for $1,000. So yeah, $1,000 is great. It won't be bad for anyone, by the way. So I'm just trying to do. So I'm going to do Gothic. And what is more Gothic than Dracula? Draculea, Vlad Tepish, the son of the devil, the son of the dragon, or whatever. So let's go and do Draculea. And by the way, for the guys that just getting here, this is Gus, and we are gonna start drawing. So welcome again, and we have the Clipstudiopaint preview. So I'm gonna create a new art, 300. Oh no, no. Let me go. Illustration, yeah, custom sizes. A4. Yeah, 300 dpi is okay. So I'm gonna start creating this thing. First, as you can see here, I have a bunch of references. How can you get so much references in just one place, and you can just navigate through them to see about the, you know, the wrinkles and the rub and that kind of stuff? How you can do that? Well, that's easy, because I have a problem called a program called Pure Reef, yeah, Reef at the sandal. Pure Reef. If you go to these places, I don't know what is the name. Let's go to my friends. Let me see, where is my. Oh, by the way, I have a Discord. Window, let me minimize. Yeah, let me go to my restream chat to see somebody here. Okay, so let me go to this guy again. So welcome to go to drawing with us and let's start drawing something.
Well, as I told you, I have this Pure Reef. Pure Reef, I'm finding with that some nice guy that I'm just following in YouTube. His name is Ahmed Aldori. By the way, Ahmed Aldori uses Wacom too, but he's not using the display. He's using a graphic tablet, one of these slate tablets. The graphic tablet or pen tablet, not the pen display. So he's using a tablet. And he makes very, very good art. That is great. And let's see this, because right now I want to do something for Halloween. Not that I believe in that. I don't believe in that at all. Don't tell anyone. I don't believe in Halloween. How am I able? But Clipstudiopaint is asking for Gothic, and what is more Gothic than a vampire, and what is more Gothic than Dracula, and what is more Gothic than the best movie ever done from such character, which is the Francis Ford Coppola versions in the 90s. Bram Stoker's Dracula, best Dracula ever. It's not the stupid vampires from the Twilight. I like the Neil Jordan movie, Interview with the Vampire, the Neil Jordan movie. Not the other, Neil Jordan. By the way, Akasha was very nice portrayed by Elijah at that time. But anyway, let's start doing this Draculea. So I need this guy. And I need this guy in a menacing pose. Because I like to see him this way. So I'm going to start. By the way, I'm going to use the real pencils. First, I'm going to make a pencil. Okay, this is the pencil. Yeah, this is the pencil. Okay. Yeah, it's bigger. So, let's see what we are going to do with this guy. I love the hairdo. The hairdo is the best thing that ever done in this movie. I mean, I know the guy is a Japanese guy. One of the best, if you ask me. This pose is absolutely fantastic. Yeah, the guy is spooky. Okay, so all the doesn't even have eyebrows. It looks pretty much like a Joker from Hell or something like that with this kind of hairdo, which is pretty much a hairdo that I've seen in many this medieval. This is Dracula, was guy from the spooky enough. Oh, you like it, spooky enough. So let's see what else we are gonna do with this guy.
Okay.
That's what he meant. So I keep the guy.
So we are just cropping this guy and putting back in this place.
Because I understand.
Okay.
I mean, the flavor is not okay.
And we come back to this.
Here. Let me show you the streak. Where are my rulers? Well, this is the symmetrical. Symmetrical rule. Let me make a symmetrical rule. Just right here.
So what I kind of do is
okay, this is my Dracula, and yeah, I like this. Yeah, so we can get rid of the fella here. So we could make all these layers the same. Cool, this is my sketch. Gonna merge all the layers. Yeah, okay. Yeah. I got rid of the ruler. And okay, we are going to create a new layer, and this new layer is gonna be for the for this real guy here, the tick for the sketch. But I don't want this guy to look like sketch, so something like this. Yeah. Oh, it's kind of nice. So I will start doing that. Oh, I'm doing in the layer. I'm not supposed to do this.
Okay, guys, this is the first part. We have the line art. This is my line art, actually.
Yeah, I have to do something. I almost forgot this. Okay, this is my line art. And, hey, by the way, if you guys want to paint this by yourself or drawing by yourself, I can just either put the sketch or the line art for you to just download it and try to play a little, see what you can do in colors or probably composition or something else. Okay. Yeah, he has an extremely big head. I don't know if I wanted to do it that way, but it looks nice. I have no problem with that. So, yep, this is the guy. So we'll start doing the colors. What is the colors of the guy? The guy's like bluish with some red. Here is totally, but it's pale. So I guess it's like this pale for the regular kind of color. Let's see. And this is the midterms. Okay, this is the midterms. Why not using different layers for the midtones, for the lights, and for the darker tones? Oh, because I'm trying to do this as the way you will do it if you are using traditional art. I know this is digital art, but I'm trying to do this way. And I know that I can use the other things, but as I told you, I'm trying to do this my particular kind of way. Okay. There's some white. He's got some green.
Any question? Is the guy creepy enough?
Yes, he's creepy enough.
Well, we'll finish with the... Wait. Let's go and do the... I'm gonna see. The hair. The hair is totally gray. This guy has gray hair. So the hair is totally gray. Actually, it's not gray, it's white. Let's see, this is the mid-tone. I forgot the hands. Let me get back to the hands. A minute. The hands. They are very creepy. They need to be this. So let's start with your hair. Let's go back to your hair. Hair is gonna be like this.
Okay, nasty hair. And next thing, where is this? It's totally white. Okay, so moving on. So I need a little more on this from this size. Looking good. Pretty terrifying. You don't want to see the guy.
You're right.
So yeah, let's start. Now we have this. Thank you. Okay. So the next step is the robe. So this robe is going to be something like this red, actually, totally red. So this guy is here. The robe has to be underneath because I don't want to have him draw this robe. So I see again the robe colors. So it's supposed to light. Light is more. It's always nice. Yes, red and yellows. So let's start this with red. With this robe. So, let's see. Okay. Oh, still with me, guys. We are almost done with this guy. So I need some whites. Okay, let's do the rope. Let's do the rope. Rope in a different plane. Let's do the rope. We're going to rope right now. Which is white. But it's extraordinarily white. That is the contrast. So. And we need more white. Okay, and let's do something extra. Oh yeah, we have to do the sword. I'm gonna make the sword in the same layer as the rope. So I need something like this. Thank you. And what about the handle? Well, the handle is going to be root. So yeah, this is the outside of the handle. I want the handle to be root. Let's see, down background. Oh my gosh,
this background.
So for the background, let me see what I can do for the background. Super cool, right? Oh, that is what happens when you are not using Let's see. Oh. using this.
Okay, this is my version of Dracula.
Oh, you like it, guys? I probably are gonna make some little twitching here and there. I'm gonna see my stem. Yeah, that's my stem. Oh, it gets smaller. Oh yeah, let me see. Oh yeah, probably. Nah. Probably in yellow. Probably red. Okay, way better. Well, guys, this is my Gothic art, aka Mr. Draculea. This is my version, and I hope you guys like it. Let me get to the better camera. Well, thank you guys for joining me. I just finished. Let me show you again. This is my Draculea or Dracula. This is my version, and I'm probably gonna tweak some things later on, but I can say that it's pretty much finished. So I hope you guys like it. This is like some sort of mangish. My version of the mangish. Let me show you. Expression. This guy is pretty menacing. Well, thank you guys for joining me, and don't forget to support these artists. How can you support me? Well, there's two ways. First, it's free, and just subscribe to this channel. The more you subscribe, the more chances that I have to monetize this. And by the way, also there is a place called Coffee. ko-fi.com, coffee.com. I'm gonna put the link in the description of the video. Well, you can support me there and buy me a coffee. For the guys who buy me like 10 coffees per month or something like that, I can give you a copy of black and white, actually, the line art of your favorite drawing that I've done in the channel, the one that you like the most. I can just draw it and then sign a copy, and that's it. And the guys who buy me more than 5 copies per month, probably 10 copies per month, well, I can give you a color copy like this one. Okay, and it's gonna be, actually this is 300 dpi, so it's pretty big, so you can just blow it up to something a little bigger, like 8x10. I don't know the other sizes, but you can do it. And just remember, this channel is just support and brought to you by me. Everything that I have is what I own. I bought the tablet because it was a very nice price. I bought the Clipstudiopaint because it was a very nice price. And actually, I didn't regret it because I guess I'm doing some sort of interesting things here. Well, thank you so much for this. Thank you so much for joining me.